from Hillsborough County. The school board is on notice tonight from the state. That notice is shape up or risk a takeover by the state of Florida. Florida Education Commissioner Richard Corcoran putting the threat in writing today in a letter to the Hillsborough County School Board. Fox 13's Aaron Mesmer first broke the story, joined us now live from the school board headquarters in Tampa to explain the issues. Aaron, seems like this is the line in the sand. Seems like Corcoran's really putting his foot down, didn't he?
Yeah, Mark, there are two issues at stake here. The first involves the district's massive budget deficit. Commissioner Corcoran says this is something that needs to be resolved immediately, and he thinks that Superintendent Addison Davis needs to be part of that solution and in a discussion with the school board. The other involves Superintendent Addison Davis and speculation that Davis's job might be on the line.
Florida Education Commissioner Richard Corcoran sounds disgusted about Hillsborough School's budget deficit. In a letter sent Thursday to school board chair Lynn Gray, Corcoran calls the situation a point of crisis, and he threatens to take over the district if the problem isn't resolved or if Superintendent Addison Davis is fired. Corcoran wrote that the board's support of Superintendent Davis is essential. It's unclear if Davis's job is on the line, but Gray says his leadership is a concern. And it's a reason she called an emergency board meeting for Friday.
We have a corrective plan, as you know, or you might have heard, for our superintendent.
Gray hasn't said exactly what the meeting will be about or whether it'll involve potentially parting ways with the superintendent. He's come under fire for his handling of the budget deficit, which exceeds $100 million and is a problem that existed before he arrived last year.
There seems to be a lot of frustration with the way it's being done, and the lack of collaboration, not only school site, but with the community.
Meanwhile, on Wednesday, Congresswoman Kathy Castor put the budget blame on the state. She says Florida is near the bottom in the U.S. for per pupil funding. And Castor says the state is withholding two of the three rounds of federal COVID relief funds from districts. In Hillsborough, she says that's more than $700 million she believes could help stabilize the district.
They're slow walking it to an extent that I had to write a letter to the governor to say, release our funds. We need them in Hillsborough County.
But in his letter, Commissioner Corcoran says that money can't be used to balance a budget. He says that would be a temporary fix. Corcoran says the district needs a permanent solution, and he writes that he's given the board since December to come up with one, and members now have 20 days to do so or risk a state takeover. Parent turned activist Damaris Allen is livid, and she believes this is the exact scenario where that federal relief money is needed.
That's the reason the federal government is giving us this funding, is because they know school districts need it to make it through this.
And in a statement to Fox 13, Superintendent Davis said, quote, "We've done everything to minimize the impact on individuals, but I know that the budget decisions have affected our teachers, students, families, and school-based administrators. All of this has been necessary to avoid a state takeover, and I look forward to working with the board in the weeks and months ahead." Now, board chair Lynn Gray says she is disappointed that Commissioner Corcoran is getting involved. She believes that this kind of discussion should be between the elected board and the superintendent, and that the state should not get involved. Mark?
Yeah, and especially to put a 20-day timeline on it already, things are going to happen quickly, and I know you're going to keep following it for us. Yeah. Aaron Mesmer at the Hillsborough County School Board, thanks. Now,